สวัสดีครับคุณณรงค์ชัยว่องธนวิโมก The Senior Executive Vice President and Chief Financial Officer of CIMB Thai Bank. How are you, คุณณรงค์ชัย?
I'm very well, ครับ. Thank you very much.
So what is the bank's business strategy for AEC or the ASEAN Economic Community, which will be effective in 2015?
Okay. Thank you very much for having us here.
Yes.
The first thing is for CIMB Thai, what we do is we start to roll out some of the ASEAN for you as a tagline.
That's here.
So as you see here, whereby what we do here is actually we are trying to embed the thing of ASEAN into our people, such that when we do marketing of our CIMB Thai or CIMB Group, we are actually focused on ASEAN.
Yes.
So that's what we do. So we start off with ASEAN for you tagline. We launched about a few months ago.
Yes.
So with that is, I think the key thing to the ASEAN for you is we have something whereby we try to send some message.
Yes.
Whereby ASEAN for you is like ASEAN is our market. It's a local market. It's a home market.
Yes.
So we're not talking about Thailand as a market. We're not talking about Indonesia as a market or Malaysia as a market. We talk about ASEAN.
That's
the market. So what we do, what we think, when we have some business, we are looking at the business that actually offered to ASEAN community. So whether it's a product, whether it's a businesses, whether it's a deal, whether it's a client, whether it's client coverage, we are looking at into the various way whereby, for example, like if you have ATM card. ATM card in Thai, open up in, let's say you have a bank account with us. You have an ATM card. This ATM can go out and use everywhere in ASEAN.
You're saying that an ATM card issued in by CIMB Thai can be used in other ASEAN country also?
Yes. The thing is, ATM card from any bank can use anywhere in the world.
Yes.
But with a cost, with a fee. Some bank charge like 100, some bank charge 200. But for us, if you see CIMB Thai card or whichever CIMB Group issued card, you go to looking at the ATM of that of CIMB in Singapore, Malaysia, or Indonesia, you can get the
free of charge.
Free of charge.
I see.
Free of charge. So that's how we can do the regional linkage.
So this one way is to leverage the ASEAN strategy.
Absolutely, absolutely. So it's like, and then a few other things like we try to synergize the way we do things here. Whereby, if you walk into the let's say preferred banking lounge in CIMB Thai, you walk into preferred banking lounge in Indonesia, it's exactly the same. The way we do decoration could be slightly different, but pretty much get the same flavor.
I see. And in ASEAN countries, how many markets you are now having these services?
Okay, we start off in Malaysia.
Yes.
Then the bank took over, the group actually bought into Niaga in Indonesia.
Yes.
And then they opened up two branches in Singapore.
Yes.
And then they bought into CIMB Thai. And the latest addition in terms of ASEAN is actually Cambodia.
I see.
Whereby we opened up two branches in late last year, and by the end of this year, we should have about five branches in Cambodia.
I see. In Thailand, how many branches?
We are at 156 at the moment.
Is it the biggest retail network?
Not there.
Malaysia?
Malaysia. If you combine the whole CIMB group, we are covering we have the largest coverage of retail network in ASEAN, covering from Chiang Rai to Bali.
We
have about 1,000 branch.
Chiang Rai, northern Thailand to Bali, Indonesia.
Yes.
It's a big, long space.
Yes. And then we look into some other ASEAN countries. Vietnam also in the pipeline. We have a JV there. Joint venture. We also have a rep office in Burma.
Yes.
We just recently opened up a rep office. As an investment banking license in Sri Lanka, where they have a very that now we go beyond slightly beyond ASEAN. Whereby we're looking to Sri Lanka. We also opened up a rep office in India recently.
India is part of ASEAN. Part six. When we have China, Japan, Korea, part three, and then India and Australia and New Zealand, part six.
Yes.
I see.
So that's what we are focused on in terms of try to cover as much as possible in terms of ASEAN. Mm. Some of the countries in the ASEAN community we also look after. We also look into, like Philippines, also part of our radar screen as well.
Maybe you can explain more a bit on the branding strategy when you have the theme that ASEAN for you. What about your marketing, your advertising campaign so far?
So, if you see our first TV commercial,
yes,
we try to say by a guy who actually walked into Simi Thai branch,
yes,
open up the door, and then actually he looked into the beach in Thailand, and he just stumbled and walked into, just turned out to be he opened up a door into Indonesia,
yes,
into Malaysia, into Singapore. Mm-hmm. So that's how we pretty much like try to show that our market is ASEAN, and we actually try to put some of the branding such that like CMB PGA, which will happen in
our
next year. In our next month.
Yes.
And then we also look into
about the golf.
The golf.
Yes.
That's the only US PGA events in Asia.
Sponsored by
CIMB Group, yes. And then we also have leveraged the CIMB Foundation through the community link, the CSR program, which also cover across Asia, ASEAN. We also have several advertisements, if you see. Some of them are actually, most of them actually coming from the group, whereby we try to, when you see the advertising in the newspaper from three or four countries, they come out the same.
I see. And in your opinion, Khun Nolong Chai, what is the potential of ASEAN community? We have now more than 580 million people in 10 countries in ASEAN. What is the potential?
I think on the outset of it, ASEAN economy is very big. I think we cannot deny that now the epicenter of the world economy is actually shift to the east. Whereby we're looking at this
China,
if you're looking at this three or four time zones,
yes,
we are looking at very high growth rate. We're still growing very well, even though some hiccups. If you notice, like two years ago when they have a Hamburg crisis.
Yes, 2008.
Mm-hmm. In Asia, the growth rate is still quite phenomenal.
Quick recovery.
Right. Let's say in Singapore, like a few years ago, they like still double digit.
Yes.
So we are doing quite well. So it's like, and then also the trade flow between in what we call intra-ASEAN, between from Thailand into Asia, into
within
ASEAN is growing pretty phenomenal.
Double digit.
Yes, I think it's really very good, very high growth rate. So it's the kind of thing whereby we should focus on. This is the market that we should be in.
And in your opinion, what are the common characteristics of consumers in ASEAN for banking services? If Thai consumers or Malaysian or Indonesian, they have similar preferences for banking?
I think consumer are the same.
Yes.
Try to max out everything. So of course, let's say you have money. The first thing you want to have is you want to get the highest return in your deposits, or with a sort of securities.
Yes.
If you borrow money, you want to get the lowest interest rate paid.
Of course.
That's pretty much common characteristics. But one thing that we also look into is there are some certain needs.
Yes.
Whereby it's actually specific to certain group of customers, like. Let's say I'm a SME customer.
Yes.
I want to do some business in Indonesia. Then I don't know who to go after. So the best thing to do is let's call it a bank, and the bank can help.
Yes.
So this is where CIMB actually come in, fit in, whereby we actually offer the solutions over some services cross border. Whereby we also have some deals that we actually have evidences, like last year we also listed one of the largest rubber. Dual listed in Singapore stock market.
And which are the other market? Singapore.
We did that company.
Only in Thai and the Singapore market.
Thai company listed in Singapore market.
I see.
So that's how we see, and it's pretty much how we leverage on the group networks.
that's on the corporate, on the SME side. What about the retail customer?
Retail customer, I think we are looking to something like we can offer some similar solution for, let's say, expats who come actually work here. Let's say, let's take Malaysian who work here. We probably can offer some businesses, some services that they can get in their home, in the market in Malaysia, in here. We pretty much leveraging the risk framework, leveraging the product suite, and those kind of things.